session was prepared by me and my colleague, but we have not long time, so we decided one of us speak in. We are coming from Portugal, from this library. It's one of the most important libraries all over the world. It's from the 18th century, and we have some good reasons to think about digitizing the collection, and we have thank you for being in this project. So we are going to try to be fast with the communication because we have a lot of things to say, but we don't have time. So we are trying to say what is important in patrimonial libraries and how to make these things. So we try to think not only on our library, but in the others, sometimes smaller than our library, but always related with communication between the people that work in different libraries and always the economic aspects. Because we don't have money, we must think about that, how to make more with less. So it's our preoccupation in this moment about the digitizing the collections. We have here some of the most important things that we are going to try to explain again. Okay, low-cost digitization in heritage libraries, practical issues. We have a problem when we work with old books. We have sometimes a big, big problem that is the selection of books and documents. We have another problem is the target. Who goes to benefit with the digitizing? So the target is very important. And the intellectual property, as we have listened in this morning, is very important also. Select books, how to do. We have different problems. We must choose. It's impossible to digitize everything. So we must choose, we must have a criteria to do that. So we have some lines and we think that it's not good everything because sometimes we must relate it, the truth of the books with the target that want to share that kind of information. So we think there are these kind of things very, very important to choose the books to digitize. In first, the value, relevance and rareness of the documents, and we have our own case. In this moment, we have only digitizing some manuscript documents, some books that are rare or they are unique in Portugal or all over the world, because we have some books that are only one, two or three books all over the world, the same book. So it's one point very important. Another is the fragility of the documents. Everybody knows that some documents from the 15th, 16th century are very fragile. So we must preserve, we must be the idea how to preserve. It's not necessary everybody touch in the book. So if we make the access online or by computer, it's better for the document. So it's a second kind of reason. A third is, and they are related with special collections, and everybody knows that in some parts there are special collections, people that are family archives, small libraries that belongs to small families, so it's another kind of selection. And another factor is the books that are more requested. Imagine we have an important book and lot of people want to see the book. It's not good for an old book, everybody see the book and use the book. So it's another part. We have here some examples of different materials because some of them are very fragile. So we have a manuscript, we have a book of ours manuscript also from the beginning of the 15th century. So it's very important to use this kind of sense to see what is more important, to try to preserve all the documents. We have a case here, The Fragility. This is a book forbidden, and the Inquisition make and cut everything. So it's not good for the book to be used by people. So this is, in this case, this is an example that we have already digitizing, because we touch in the book, but when we make, we must be carefully, because it's very, very, very fragile. So it's an important. This is the bindings. This is all kinds of bindings with problems. So there is very important also. Target audience, as I told, students, research, local people, because we are near Lisbon, in our case, we are near Lisbon, but we have a specific local history. So, a lot of people that like to study local history goes to there, and it's impossible to give this kind of books to that kind of people. Intellectual property, I put only this here, I don't talk because hand talk and a lot of people say this kind of problems. We think it's not important in this moment to talk about that and to repeat what everything was told before. Low cost. We think that are the economic problems. As I told, we don't have money. I think Italy also, Bulgaria also. I think it's a problem that is all over the world when we talk about culture. So we must think and we agree with Andrea when say the economic part is very, very important. And we think that it's important to see the examples of other institutions. If other have made something, let's go to see and to see what is good and what is not good. Why we don't discover nothing? We are trying to adapt to our institution the best solution. So let's see what the others have done before. And we seem to share experiences between librarians can be a solution. It's important to see and to talk with other persons. Don't stay in one room, don't stay in one library. Try to go, to talk, to discuss, to see, and find ways, best ways of doing the things. And why? Because we have problems with resources, and the resources are humans, materials, and financial. So we must talk with others to try to find solutions and to get the best to not spend a lot of money and to be economical available for us and for the others. And to have the best of the results that we can give to our public and to our institution also. And in this case, I think it's important to share with you what we are thinking now in Portugal. It was for us very important to be a partner of this process. of this project also because it was the first experience for us. But it put us thinking, and it put us to talk with other public, with other colleagues. So for us it's very, very important. And we are trying to say to you what we are doing and the benefits for us and for the others, in this case in Portugal, with this project and with this thinking and perhaps the way we can go. Okay. We belongs to a big institution. We have in this institution all these libraries. They are different libraries. We have patrimonial libraries like our and Ajuda. We have libraries related with art. We have libraries related with archaeology. We have libraries related with museums, archives. So we have all kinds of libraries that you can imagine. But we belong all to the same institution that is named Direção Geral do Património Cultural. This is a big institution in Portugal, and we have this. So we have another problem. All those libraries are all over the country. They are not in one place. They, we have libraries since the north until Lisbon. So we have all part of north of Portugal with libraries that belongs to that institution. And what do we think? In October, we are going to have a meeting of all libraries, and the head of libraries of institutions knows that we belong to this project. So they propose to us to make a presentation about the project, about everything that are related with this. And we are going to do that presentation, and we have an idea to make a team, a small team, to think about this kind of things, to think, to write some considerations to our heads and propose something. And what we think is propose something to digitize the books, but a mobile one. And why? Because it can move in the country, and we can make a map with, in this month I have the equipment, the other library has another month, so it's not necessary have 20 equipments, but one equipment can move over, all over the libraries, and it's a very important thing because economically it's more easier to buy one than 20. So we are going to propose, we are studying that kind of things, and we have some ideas, but we don't know yet how. After this we are going to think better, and this is a kind of thing that we can propose. It was developed by Graz. We think it's an idea, why not, but not the only idea. We put only this because it's a part. We can choose another, but as I told, is talking with the other libraries, is thinking what is the better for everybody. So it's what we're thinking to do. And thank you again.